There are many different types and classifications of exoskeletons, as we saw before. One thing they have in common is that they were all designed to augment human performance in a variety of tasks, making us stronger or increasing our endurance. Do you still remember some of the possible applications? Were there any that you were surprised to learn about? In this video, we will explore the three main applications of exoskeletons in some more depth, which are military use, industrial use, and rehabilitation support. By the end, you will also understand the precise type of exoskeleton that this MOOC is focused on. Ready to find out more? Let's start out by talking about our soldiers, who on average carry around 45 kilograms of weight and are sometimes asked to carry even more. Only imagine the physical exhaustion this leads to, let alone the other physical complications, such as heavy back injuries, that have been reported to be chronic in over 30% of them. Now, exoskeletons offer a solution to this problem, with many designs focusing on relieving strain on muscle and joints. The military applications have been extensive. As such, the devices help to protect soldiers from strain injuries and allow them to achieve beyond their optimal performance. Here you can see some examples that have been explored by the US Army and were developed with the help of their funding. This is a lower body type of exoskeleton called Onyx that primarily boosts leg capacity. Another one has a more specific focus on supporting the foot and ankle, called ExoBoot, and has the advantage of being easier to integrate into any army operation. These are just two examples, but with the large governmental funds, many more have been developed recently. Whereas from a physical point of view, exoskeletons indeed serve a great purpose during physically demanding operations in the military, it also stirs up ethical discussions about whether or not we want to exploit technology in such a manner. Using the devices to turn us into some kind of superhumans. What's your stand on this? Besides military purposes, we've already seen how exoskeletons could be of use in the industry branch. Again, the promise of reducing injuries, relieving workers from extreme fatigue, and creating ways to improve efficiency and productivity, and thus reduce costs, are all advantages. Overall, you could view these types of exoskeletons as a bridging solution between the extremes of fully manual work and the kind of tasks that demand industrial robots. Finally, exoskeletons are increasingly being used for rehabilitation purposes in order to help patients with impaired motor functions. Both age-related pathologies as well as the incidence of spinal cord injuries have been reported to have increased over the past years. Since impaired mobility can reduce life expectancy a lot, it is necessary that these patients have access to rehabilitation training. Therefore, exoskeletons have been developed as assistive devices to help disabled people regain their ability to stand and walk. Here you see one of the best-known examples that was developed by ExoBionics. We will explore this particular application in more depth in one of the upcoming videos this week. But now that you've been introduced to the main concept of exoskeletons and understands the principal types and classifications, it is time to focus on the particular type of exoskeleton that will come back throughout this course. We will focus on the powered lowered extremity type of exoskeletons, especially used for rehabilitation purposes. To make this even more specific, our point of reference exoskeleton was particularly designed for patients with paraplegia. Don't know what exactly that is? Don't worry, we will talk you through it in the next video where you will learn more about this condition.